upcoming designer, your job is to design, of course, but also to present your work to your potential client in an attractive way. And that means that you would show them different varieties based on the type of business you're designing for. I know we're notoriously known as a 3D logo channel, but we need to start adding variety when we are showing our customers our design. Join me, let's design this logo using Canva and Photopea. I found done by Visme that talks about 14 types of logos and how to use them. I will link it in the description. It helps us fine-tune our craft as logo designers and the type of logos that we create. To start creating your logo, for this quick and easy one, you're going to press T to add text, or your forward slash and you're going to add text. You're going to start typing the name of the business, and to make things nice and interesting and make the logo stand out, you're going to have a bold and a thinner font on the name of your logo. So I'm going to use myself for this one, and I'm going to change the font and use League Spartan. And we're going to duplicate that and add the rest of the name of the business, which in this instance is my second name. But to make it nice and thin, but pair it with a font that works well, we're going to use the Agrandir Thin. And we're going to change color and make it a nice gray for both. And we're just going to change and make it colorful. So the U, we're going to make red. The YouTube, we're also going to make red. That takes care of the words part of the logo. I do like to create a nice icon on the logo itself. So we're going to add a circle. And our circle shape, we're going to change that color and make it a nice red. Because we are YouTube coaches, well, I am a YouTube coach, so red with YouTube rhymes and goes very well. And then I'm going to add a growing arrow. So I went and I found this arrow, and I'm just gonna add it to my round shape, and I'm gonna add a graph for showing growth. And then I'm gonna add a square and zoom so ever in so that I'll be able to adjust this and make sure that it is exactly the size that I want. So for a growing graph, I'm gonna change that and make it white. And then let me just see how small it is. I'm happy with it. And I'm gonna duplicate the shape and create a growing graph. Because it's grouped, I can size it so that it fits this design. And I'm gonna zoom back out, and I'm gonna group this, and then I'm gonna move it over to our logo here. And that's it. That's your logo. That's your 2D logo. That is a Wordmark logo, but with an icon that represents the brand. I'm happy and I love it. Then I'm gonna go and download the logo. So I'm gonna go and download it as a transparent background. And I'm going to download the one that we did together, number 2. And then it's downloaded. Because I want the white that I've created on this logo to have gaps on there, I'm going to upload it back on Canva, and then I can be able to remove the white that I've added on there. So I'm just gonna drag it to the uploads, edit to my design, and then click on edit image and select remove background. This is a functionality available on Pro. If you want to trial it and upgrade to Canva Pro, then click on the description link below. It will change the way you design on Canva. Then I'm going to nicely align and size my design, click on apply, and then I'm going to download it as a transparent background, and then I can go over to Photopea to convert it to 3D. If you would like to put it on a business card, this is another reason why it is such a good idea to have a Canva Pro. You can use the smart mockups that are available on Canva. So on your landing page on Canva, there's different kinds of smart mockups that you could use. But most of these beautiful ones are Canva Pro. However, they do have free ones that you could use. I'm just saying it will add much more variety on your designing skills. Next, we're going to jump in on www.photopea.com and we're going to be using a PSD template. And we're going to click PSD template, and then we select mockups. Then I want to use this office room logo because I'm designing for a business. Then I would double click on it or click on the link so that it loads. Take note of the steps because I would double click where it says your logo here. But I want you to take note of how the designer has positioned his example for us. So it is huge. It's covering almost the full canvas itself, which tells you when you're uploading your own 2D design, don't leave it as a small little piece, because then when you convert it, it becomes a small little design and you don't understand why yours doesn't look like the designer's or mine. So make sure every time you're using your mockups, and have a look and see how the designer is guiding you on how you should be placing your 2D logo. So now that we know, we're going to click on the eye and we're going to hide it. And then we're going to click and drag our design. As you can see, when you land it in here, it lands as a small design. So we want to make it huge, like the designer showed us. Then I'm happy. I click on the tick mark and you press Command S or Control S. Design is changed to Smart Object. Then you click once where it says 3D mockup logo, and then you wait, and then your design is absolutely stunning and gorgeous. Then you're going to go File, Export as a PNG, and then you have your design as you want, and you click on Save. The next video you could watch to elevate your design skills even further is this wavy logo that we did. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on the next video.